Hi.
Let's get back to our presentation about tobacco. The teacher said we had to care about the accuracy of our information. Let's go.
Look, I found a very interesting graphic.
Yes?
My graphic seems to me more secure in terms of information. Let me share my screen.
Why are you saying that?
Yeah, I mean, isn't this document looks way more correct than your Instagram post?
In fact, I was correct. Zenin's document comes from a secure source, which is the INSEE, a national organism that provides official statistics. On the other hand, Honda sent a surprise from a startup company selling cigarettes. Their interest can influence the accuracy of the calculation. So we should always be careful about where we get our information from.
This means my website is a good source to use.
But what are exactly official statistics?
Indeed, the INSEE gives official statistics. It is easy to identify them, as they are only given by a specific list of public statistical institutes, of which the INSEE is one. Statistics have an important place in our lives, especially during the pandemic of COVID-19. They must be relevant, objective, and accurate for users to be well informed.
Oh, great! That means we have to use relevant sources. However, Ron's post was nonsense. But what if something seems right?
Oh, I get it now. So it may seem right, but that doesn't mean it is.
Misinformation is dangerous in our society. As this graph shows, French people trust more the information provided on television and the written press because it is more often official statistics. Information shared on social networks are the least reliable according to French people. So we have to be careful and look for official statistics because misinformation is everywhere.